Hello, hi everyone. Welcome back to Woo Can Cook. My name is Wesley, and this is a show where we are slowly cooking our way through all of the food from my childhood. Today we're diving back into our series dedicated to Hawaiian comfort food with a shot at a small bite classic that has been on my list for some time now, which is the iconic Hawaiian onigiri known as spamasubi. For those unfamiliar, the concept of a spamasubi is not terribly complicated, particularly given that onigiri itself is not super complicated either. It is essentially a molded piece of sushi rice layered with a spoonful of teriyaki sauce and topped with a seared piece of the famous canned mystery meat known as spam. As with most onigiri, its compact and easily transportable nature makes it an extremely common snack found in corner stores and quick stops all around the island, often with increasingly more complicated variations. For our version today, we will of course start with the required classic spamasubi, but then I thought it might also be fun to dive into some of the more interesting variations that I have come across too, including a quick miso teriyaki sauce, our spam katsu masubi, crispy seared spamasubi, and just about everything else that I could possibly think of too. Okay, so let's get into it. Okay, so kicking things off here first, we're starting off with our teriyaki sauce, which we'll be building from scratch today. Obviously, if you'd like, you can of course buy this stuff off the shelf, but honestly, this dish is so simple to make that, you know, why not? So, up first here are a couple of fresh aromatics to add to our sauce. This is 4 cloves of crushed and minced garlic, followed by 1 inch or about 1 tablespoon of fine minced ginger. Now, a teriyaki sauce, to my taste, iconically has the flavors of sugar, soy sauce, and rice vinegar, although I do think that the sugar may be the single most important aspect though, so we'll want to be careful not to lean too savory here today. Up first, this is 4 tablespoons of soy sauce and a single tablespoon each of sesame oil, rice vinegar, and mirin. Then I'm rounding this out with a half tablespoon of dark soy sauce, followed by what ended up being 6 tablespoons of brown sugar. Finally, I think you could likely stop right here and come away with a pretty standard teriyaki sauce if you want, but I'm rounding mine out here with a single tablespoon of white miso paste as well to give us a little bit of extra umami. Over on the stove, I'm adding this all to a wok over medium-low heat and bringing this to a gentle simmer, then I'm adding in my garlic and ginger, followed by a cornstarch slurry comprised of 2 tablespoons of cornstarch dissolved in water. We're giving this all a mix until a thickened sauce forms. Here's the remaining 2 tablespoons of brown sugar as promised. Then I'm removing this all from heat and setting aside for a moment while we get to work on our rice next. Okay, so for the most part, our sushi rice should look fairly similar to any other standard rice with a few additional tweaks for texture. This is 2 cups of jasmine rice that I'm adding to a strainer so that we may rinse it out until the water runs clear. This is going to wash away the excess starch in the rice for us so that we don't end up with overly starchy, mushy rice. Then I'm combining this with equal parts water plus a single piece of kombu or dried sea kelp for some nice added umami. Then this is heading into my rice cooker like any other rice. Once it's done cooking, I'm removing this kombu, then adding it to a large mixing bowl so that we may combine our rice with a single tablespoon of rice vinegar. As I do so, I'm also being very careful to use my paddle at a slight angle, which should help us prevent broken grains in the rice as well. Moving on to our spam next, we're slicing these into 1/4 inch pieces and reserving our can for our rice mold later on. Now, as many of you likely know, spam found its way into Hawaiian cuisine during World War II as a US military ration because of its extended shelf life. This, of course, brings along with it the stigma of it being a lowbrow canned meat, particularly given that it's not super clear exactly what kind of meat this is. At certain points, it seems that Hormel had claimed that it's made from pork shoulder, but they're also not particularly committed to this either, though, it seems. Either way, what's most important here is that it does contain a high amount of fat in it, meaning that it will brown very nicely in the pan. In retrospect, I do kind of wish that I had added a little bit of oil to the pan to help the browning process along, though I do think that we still managed a decent sear without it too. Back over on the cutting board, we're using our reserved can as a mold to form our onigiri by packing it tightly with rice, yielding these nicely spam-formed rice patties. I'm adding a spoonful of our teriyaki sauce here, followed by a strip of nori sealed with a bit of water, and we've got ourselves a basic spam musubi. Now, if you want to, as far as I'm concerned, this is absolutely an acceptable stopping point if you simply want to start shoveling spam into your mouths here. If we stopped here, I think this took me something like maybe 10 minutes to assemble altogether, and is absolutely the nostalgic Hawaiian snack of my childhood. The only thing that's missing here is a little bit of sand getting stuck in my teeth, because I always remember eating these on the beach from a cooler. But for the bold, I thought it would be fun to take a look at some variations to our spam musubi. I'll admit, some of which worked well, and some were kinda weird. Either way though, here we go. Up first, how about let's try a crispy seared rice spam musubi, inspired by the crispy seared salmon onigiri that we made a few months back. We're starting off by making a standard spam musubi as we normally would, packed tightly with our rice mold, then wrapped in nori. Then we're adding these to a skillet over medium heat with a fair amount of oil in the pan, and searing these for 2 minutes per side. As the moisture on the rice surface begins to evaporate, we'll start forming this beautiful golden crust around the edges, yielding a lovely, crispy, crunchy spam musubi. This one was honestly one of my favorites that we came up with, because I just think the contrast of textures really brings the whole thing to life. But we also didn't really add much to the actual composition here though, so let's go a little fancier. How about an avocado and egg spam musubi? Now, what you'll want to do here is slice open your avocado last so that it won't start to brown in the open air as you work. As a sucker for mise en place, however, I did this first, as you can see, before we even fried the spam, which yielded for us some slightly browned avocados. Whoops. In any case, I'm whisking up a quick scrambled egg with kosher salt, then I've got a wok over medium heat, which we're adding 2 tablespoons of oil to so that we may fry a quick egg patty here. We're layering this on top of our rice patty once again, followed by our teriyaki sauce, egg, avocado, and finally our nori strip to bind this monstrosity together, yielding what I would describe as the most California brunch cuisine spam musubi that I think I have ever had. This one is definitely not something that I have seen in a 7-Eleven in Hawaii, although I can't imagine finding it at a brunch spot here in the bay for 18 bucks though. Finally, let's try one more. How about a fried katsu spam musubi? Is this gonna work? I mean, technically you can bread and fry pretty much anything, right? Right? Alright, so I've got a standard 3-station breading setup here, comprised of a single whisked egg, panko breadcrumb, and AP flour seasoned with a pinch of kosher salt. We're adding our spam to the flour here first, coating it in egg next, and then finally in our panko to finish, applying a bit of pressure to the panko to help make sure it adheres nicely. Then over on the stove, I've got a fryer going at 350 degrees F, then I'm adding in my katsu spam and frying it for 3 to 5 minutes until golden brown. Spam is pre-cooked before it heads into the can, so we aren't too concerned about internal temps here, but only with reaching a lightly golden exterior on our panko. We're once again molding our rice patties here first. As you can see, I did this 3 times because I wasn't actually sure that this would work. Then we're topping this with our teriyaki sauce, katsu spam, and nori strips to bind it all together, and we're ready to eat. Okay, so I'll start off by mentioning that the reason that it's taken this long to tackle spam musubi on this channel is not because I forgot about it, but honestly because it would have been just too simple, y'all. There is barely a recipe involved at all with making a classic spam musubi. It's essentially just spam with rice, and if that's not a classic Hawaiian pairing, I don't know what is. So, that being said, the classic spam musubi is always going to be the nostalgia winner for me, because it's a snack that I grew up eating on every beach day and picnic that I can remember. There's just something particularly nostalgic and delicious about a spam musubi that's been wrapped in plastic wrap and held under a heat lamp for 4 hours that will never be topped. But that said, a panko fried katsu spam musubi is truly one of the greatest things that I think I have ever created. It's crispy, salty, tender, and fried to perfection, and it's just everything that I want to be eating wrapped in a single onigiri. More importantly though, I hope the general takeaway from this video is that the simplicity of a spam musubi makes it absolutely ripe for creative tweaking, so if you haven't slapped a bunch of avocado on top of a piece of spam yet, you know, you should probably try this. Okay, so that's it everyone. I hope you enjoyed this and I hope you give this one a shot. For those who are new to the channel, this one is part of a larger series dedicated to Hawaiian comfort food classics, so definitely check out that series next if you haven't yet, because there's a lot of these. As always, like, comment, subscribe, share, be nice, internetters, and I'll see you soon. Bye.